Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All praise and glorification are due to Allah the Almighty. His peace and blessings upon Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all his followers till the day of judgment. Amin. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, today we are going to talk about dhikr, remembrance of Allah. Today many of us have problems. Many of us are depressed. People have stress all over. It's not a one-man problem, but it's a global challenge. Why are we so distressed? Why don't we have happiness? Where is the happiness hidden? Should we be only waiting for the happiness of the hereafter? There's a condition that automatically bestows that child with happiness and pure peace of soul, spirit and mind. It is hidden somewhere. We just need to drop of the veil of all the evil that prevents us from reaching out peace. We need to concentrate less in the worldly affairs and concentrate much on the hereafter. That is dhikr, remembrance of Allah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned us and gave us a warning regarding concentrating on much on the dunya when he said, "Inna dunya mal'unatun, mal'unun ma fiha illa dhikrullahi wa ma walahu, wa alimun aw muta'allimun." Indeed, this world is cursed. And cursed is whatever is in it, except the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all its extensions, and a scholar and the student of deen. Meaning to say, if you are doing anything else rather than towards gaining the pleasure of Allah, remembering Allah, learning the deen of Allah, we are not in the right direction. We are getting it wrong somehow. We need to restore the happiness. We need to restore peace in our minds and lives. So how do we go about it? Let us not try to find peace in this worldly affairs, because we are trying to fish in the mountains. We are getting it all wrong if you are doing it that way. There is only peace in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for us to unlock that peace in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we need to reconnect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How do we reconnect with Him? How do we re-establish the fortified communication with Him? We need to communicate with Him effectively. It has to be a two-way communication. We need to communicate with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more oftenly and remember all His ayat and signs that He sent forth. The moment we forget His signs and ayat, that's when depression come into our lives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ, whosoever turns away from my remembrance, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعَيْشَةً ذَنْكَ, he would definitely have a stressed life, he would definitely have a constricted life, a tough life. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى, and we are going to resurrect him on the day of judgment as a blind person, not seeing anything. And you ask, رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِ أَعْمَى, why have you resurrected me blind? وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا, and I used to see on earth. Allah will say, كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى, like that you were given our signs came to you in all directions and dimensions and you forgot them, and like that you have been forgotten. Here the remembrance of Allah is in so many different forms. It comes in various ways, starting from all that which Allah has commanded us to do, and those that are optional, that will draw us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will keep us in the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you close look at this, it refers to our daily prayers that we have been ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our salawats are a great form of dhikr. It brings us closer to Allah. Allah says in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا. Oh, you who believe, remember Allah a lot, with much remembrance, with a lot of remembrance. It means we need to remember Him a lot, remembering Him by reciting the tasbihat, by reciting the Quran, by observing all the obligatory acts that have been ordained upon us. Allah also assures us that فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرُكُمْ, remember me and I will remember you. وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ, and be grateful to me and do not be ungrateful. Don't deny me. Don't deny my favors. This is an instruction from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Most High. He wants us to include Him in whatever we do in our daily lives. And that is the only way in which we can gain success. He also says, Allah, بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ, أَلَّا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ, and behold, in the remembrance of Allah do only hearts find peace. We only find peace in remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lastly, we also need not to be deceived by anything else that we possess. There are only a test in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need to be on guard. Hence, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ.
All you who believe, do not let your wealth and your children divert you from the remembrance of Allah. And
وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ.
And whomsoever does that, then they are certainly losers. They are in a lost condition. Remembering Allah will help us recognize, will help us gain recognition in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yet our ranks are elevated in this world and in the hereafter, and extends us even greater rewards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. We only need to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot of times for us to be successful in this world and in the hereafter. With this words, I say, till we meet again. Assalamu alaikum.